All right, hello everybody. This is Doug here from Young America. It's been a while. Sorry, I'm back, but I'm back now. I was moving. I was sick. I have some hectic stuff going on. There's been a lot of news since I last did a video. Very aware of that. I'm not a breaking news host. I can't report on all the news. But I am a little upset that I didn't get to some topics I wanted to talk about. Cycle moves very quickly. But what I'm trying to do here is not just, report on daily news cycles, but just talk about some more stuff that I just want to talk about some stuff that I think is just important going forward. I have a couple videos I'm gonna do. I'm gonna start right now with I'm gonna talk about some of the recent I don't know if you want to call it controversy, but some of the recent debate on Andrew Yang's subreddit and various Andrew Yang support forums over his recent attacks on Donald Trump. I'm gonna talk about my opinion on that. I don't entirely agree with either side in this. I'm gonna explain my problem with kind of each argument in this. And so, all right, yeah, all right, you get the point. Without further ado, let's get this shit going.
Once again, it's the infamous back in the house once again. Live the life, gather diamonds and guns, and now Jim pull gaps. Like a base said, pull on stems. The mall got the bomb, run out and tell the friend, drop the gem on. It's back in the house once again. Live the life, gather diamonds and guns, and now Jim pull gaps. Like a base said, pull on stems. The mall got the bomb, run out and tell the friend, drop a gem on.
All right, welcome back. So my main point here is that Andrew Yang does need to be mean to win the election. He does need to be a little bit mean at times. However, he needs to be strategically mean. And that's something I'm gonna explain a little in depth as we go along. Andrew Yang needs to be mean, but strategically mean to win the election. And when I say mean, I don't mean that he should just be slinging insults nonstop. I don't mean that he should just be insulting people for no reason or insulting people over, stuff that has nothing to do with policy, that has nothing to do with him. In regards to that's gonna nothing to do that's gonna help him win the election. But he does need to, I think there's a lot of people get this impersonation of Yang, and I think that's a lot of big reason why they like him, is that he's just this nice guy. He's this nice normal guy, who he's very smart and happens to just be, okay, here's what I want to do to fix America. And that definitely resonates with people. And at his rallies, at his events, I think that, sticking to that message of, I'm a good guy. I care about the country. I care about the people I'm trying to help, and I want to do what I think is right. I think that is something that really people are drawn to from all over the political spectrum. That's a big reason why people like Andrew Yang. However, that being said, it would be great if Andrew Yang could win the election without being mean. It would be great. But with our media environment, with the political environment, and with Andrew Yang's kind of lack of being a universal, with Andrew Yang's lack of universal name recognition, realistically, I do think that Andrew Yang is going to need to get the spotlight a little bit more, because at this point, a lot of people, even people who know about him, kind of see him as a meme. They see him as the Asian guy standing next to Joe Biden, as he's said many times. And oh, people are going to look up who's that Asian guy standing next to Joe Biden. And because of that, even people that now know who he is that didn't know who he was before, a lot of them aren't going to take him super seriously. They might say, oh yeah, I kind of like this guy, but they might be thinking, oh well, I hope when this guy, drops out or something, when this guy drops out, I'll support, Kamala Harris or Joe Biden or whoever. So basically, Andrew Yang is going to need to get a little bit more media attention, for things that he says and does during this race. And that's again, and how do you do that? You do that by making headlines. Donald Trump, not a good person, but very good at making headlines, very good at saying things that gets the media's attention. And that undoubtedly helped him. I mean, the media kind of wanted him anyway. That's a whole different story. But you can't deny that he was very good at getting media attention. That certainly helped him throughout the primary process and throughout the whole election, really. So a big part of doing this, a big part of getting this media attention is done essentially by attacking other candidates. Now, attacking other candidates does not need to literally be the name calling that Trump does. But it needs to be attacking other candidates in some substantial way. For example, Tulsi Gabbard against Kamala Harris in the last debates. Tulsi Gabbard went after Kamala Harris. She did directly. I'm sure it was intentionally her strategy to do so. She did it, and it really worked for her. Even not just getting up her poll numbers, but really knocking down Kamala Harris a peg after Kamala Harris had done the same thing to Joe Biden. So you gotta understand that this is something that candidates need to do. You do need to attack the other candidates. You need to attack Donald Trump. You need to attack other candidates and show them why you're better, not just why you're a nice guy, but why you're the better choice to be president. Now, with all that being said, you need to do it strategically, because let's face it, Andrew Yang is not Donald Trump. He is not going to be as good as insulting people. Donald Trump, I think it was Kyle Kalinske who nicknamed Donald Trump the Michael Jordan of insulting people. That's the best. That's what he's best at. He is very good at insulting people. You know, Crooked Hillary, Pocahontas. He's good at coming up with these nicknames for his political opponents. Low Energy Jeb. You know, that was a good one. He's good at coming up with these nicknames and just insulting them. And if Andrew Yang were to do the same thing with Trump, Trump could do it back. And if that's the argument that they're going to get into, that's going to be the they're going to debate based on who has the better insult nicknames for people. That's not going to be something that Andrew Yang is going to win at. So that does not mean that Andrew Yang should not insult Trump. He absolutely should. You know, and certainly there's nothing morally wrong with insulting Trump. He absolutely deserves it. However, when he called him a slob, I don't think that's something that's strategically going to work, because a slob is not the thing that Trump's voters care about. You know. I'm betting you a lot of Trump voters probably even, you know that about him and like that about him. They thought, oh, this guy eats McDonald's, you know, he's not like one of the elite, you know, of course he's, you know, a super rich billionaire, so he is elite, but you know, they're in their mind, oh, you know, this guy's just like us. He tells it like it is, you know, blah, 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 blah. And attacking him over, you know, Trump being fat, over him, you know, not being in great shape and being, you know, acting and kind of talking like a slob, that's just not the way to go, especially for a guy that has been very successful in pulling ex-Trump supporters. You know, a big part of Andrew Yang's appeal is that he does seem like a normal person. And if he attacks someone, ooh, this guy is such a slob, I am so much better than him, they are such a slob, you know, that's not the type of thing that's going to resonate with voters. I don't think it's strategically the best line of attack. Now, him saying Trump is a slob, I don't think it's really going to hurt him very much, especially at this point. But just going forward, I don't think it is the best strategy. And while it is true that he needs to win the Democratic primary, he needs to win over voters, some people might think attacking Trump more directly would be a good way of doing that. Again, I don't have anything against that. However, I just think he needs to do it strategically. And at the same time, he also does need to attack the other Democrats in the race. And that's just true. And that's something that he has not done nearly as much as I think he should. Because, again, you need to do that. Tulsi Gabbard did it very successfully with Kamala Harris. And Andrew Yang, I know, I'm sure he, because he has very different policy positions from some of these candidates, such as Joe Biden or Kamala Harris. Bernie Sanders, he's brought up the fact that Bernie Sanders' job guarantee would be a terrible idea. But have I heard about him talk that at all in the debates? Have I heard him, you know, challenge Bernie Sanders and the job guarantee at a debate or at an interview with MSNBC or CNN or Fox News even? Have not heard it once. I've only heard it in the long form interviews. And you know, I think Bernie Sanders is a good guy. I like a lot of Bernie Sanders' policies, but I think this is a bad policy. I think if Andrew Yang wants to win, he needs to pull some Bernie voters and attack Bernie on his specific policies that I do not think are good at all. Okay, so bottom line is, Andrew Yang, be mean, but do it strategically. And don't just attack Trump, but also attack your fellow Democratic candidates. Your average and real clear politics is about 1.3% now. And while there's plenty of time, you do need to move up in that race. I think you definitely have the opportunity to do so. So, you know, go get him, but be mean, but do it strategically in regards to Donald Trump, in regards to other opponents. Your expertise is on policy. It's not on insults. Donald Trump is going to beat you at the insulting game, but you're going to crush the fuck out of Donald Trump at the policy game. This is Doug here from Young America. Have a great day, motherfuckers. Signing out.